sanctum crucem tuum.
Testing, 1, 2, testing. Testing, 1, 2, testing. Okay. Well, good news, everybody. We've filled in the whole church. Every seat's been assigned for today's Mass and also Saturday. 8 o'clock's the only one that has room. So what we think we're going to do is we're also going to broadcast downstairs to the big TV, and so people who still can come, we can set up chairs downstairs, and Deacon come downstairs or and serve communion as well. So we should be good.
Please stand. O Lord, you have given everything its place in the world, and no one can make it otherwise. For it is your creation, the heavens and the earth and the stars. You are the Lord of all. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
With
your spirit. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
You sent to heal the contrite, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
King, you call sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Father, your love for us surpasses all our hopes and desires. Forgive our failings, keep us in your peace, and lead us in the way of salvation. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Let me now sing of my friend's song concerning his vineyard. My friend had a vineyard on a fertile hillside. He spaded it, cleared it of stones, and planted the choicest vines. Within it, he built a watchtower and hewed out a winepress. Then he looked for the crop of grapes, but what it yielded was wild grapes. Now, inhabitants of Jerusalem and people of Judea, judge between me and my vineyard. What more was there to do for my vineyard that I had not done? Why, when I looked for the crop of grapes, did it bring forth wild grapes? Now, I will let you know what I mean to do with my vineyard. Take away its hedge, give it to grazing, break through its wall, let it be trampled. Yes, I will make it a ruin. It shall not be pruned or hoed, but overgrown with thorns and briars. I will command the clouds not to send rain upon it, The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel, and the people of Judah are his treasured plant. He looks for judgment, but see, bloodshed. For justice, but hark the outcry. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel.
The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel.
A vine from Egypt you transplanted. You drove away the nations and planted it. It put forth its foliage to the sea, its shoots as far as the river. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. Why have you broken down its walls so that every passerby plucks its fruit? The boar from the forest lays it waste, and the beasts of the field feed upon it. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. Once again, O Lord of hosts, look down from heaven and see. Take care of this vine and protect what your right hand has planted. The Son of Man, whom you yourself made strong. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. Then we will no more withdraw from you. Give us new life, and we will call upon your name. O Lord, God of hosts, restore us. If your face shine upon us, then we shall be saved. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. Second reading is from a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing what you have learned and received and heard and seen in me. Then the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. May the Lord be in your heart and on your lips, that you might worthily and fittingly proclaim the gospel. May God bless you, Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the chief priests and the elders of the people, "Hear another parable. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard, put a hedge around it, dug a wine press in it, and built a tower. Then he leased it to tenants and went on a journey. When vintage time drew near, he sent his servants to the tenants to obtain his produce. But the tenants seized the servants, and one they beat, another they killed, and the third they stoned. Again, he sent other servants, more numerous than the first ones, but they treated them in the same way. Finally, he sent his son to them, thinking, they will respect my son. But when the tenants saw the son, they said to one another, this is the heir. Come, let us kill him and acquire his inheritance. They seized him, threw him out of the vineyard, and killed him. What will the owner of the vineyard do to those tenants when he comes? They answered him, he will put those wretched men to a wretched death and lease his vineyard to other tenants who will give him the produce at the proper times. Jesus said to them, did you never read in the scriptures, the stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone? By the Lord has this been done, and it is wonderful in our eyes. Therefore I say to you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people that will produce its faith, fruit. The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Let me sing of my friend, the song of my friend's vineyard. My friend had a vineyard planted on a fertile hillside. Three times the prophet Isaiah refers to God as my friend. That's what really hit me Monday when I started preparing for this weekend's homily. Now, I grew up in Nashville. I grew up in the Bible Belt, cradle Catholic, but you could not grow up in the South and, no matter your denomination, not know what a friend we have in Jesus. I was familiar with that, but I was not familiar with hearing the God of the Hebrew Scriptures referred to as my friend, as Isaiah does. Now, maybe I'm a little more sensitive to that now after reading Sister Lori Brink's book, What Does the Bible Say About Friendship?, where she goes through the different kinds of friendships in our life, all building up to that we are called, our vision is to be in a friendship relationship with God that we are called to deepen throughout our life. But let's go back to Isaiah. The vineyard of the Lord is Israel. Isaiah says, let me sing my song, but it's really not a song, it's a parable. And in telling that parable, Isaiah does what many of the prophets in Israel were called to do. Put forth God's complaint against God's people. What more could I have done for you that I did not do? All that God had done from calling them, but then from the Exodus on, all that I have done for you, and when I look for the fruits of that, all I find are wild grapes. Now, one of the commentaries I looked at this week said that the Hebrew that is translated wild grapes could also be translated rotten, stinking grapes. I think that's a little more graphic than wild grapes. Wild grapes you might still try to make a wine out of, but not rotten, stinking grapes. And so God asked the people, judge between me and you. What more could I have done? And God says, now what's going to happen? You're going to be conquered. You're going to be led into exile. But God still calls them the cherished plant, God's cherished plant, even though they have been unfaithful. And God says to them, if you change and practice justice, you can be restored to the land. There can be a restoration if you are willing to convert and do justice. The psalmist in today's responsorial psalm uses that same image of the vineyard. Now, I think oftentimes for us, you know, you'll hear Catholics say, well, yeah, we have three readings from Scripture at Mass every Sunday. First reading, second reading, and Gospel. But we really have four, because the responsorial psalm is Scripture. The psalmist in today's responsorial, using that image of the vineyard, the people pray to God and say, we know all the care you have given us. We know that the destruction we are experiencing, we brought on ourselves. But, God, what we're asking you to do, look on us once more as your chosen. And we promise to do better. We promise to have this conversion experience and to do justice and peace. St. Paul, writing to that young church at Philippi, but also to us, St. Paul says to them, put all your cares and anxieties on God in prayer. Offer all your petitions to God in prayer. Paul does not say, and when you do that, God is going to grant all of your desires. He says, no, but when you put all of your needs before God, you can have that peace of God which is beyond all understanding, because you've acknowledged that God's in charge. And when we acknowledge that, there can be that peace of God, which St. Paul says is beyond all understanding. It is that gift that God offers us. We get to today's gospel reading. This is getting to the climax of Matthew's gospel. This is now looking back at the prophecies like Isaiah, but also looking forward to the passion and death of Jesus. This parable, addressed once again to the chief priest and the elders, the religious leaders. The imagery used, everybody in that time would have been familiar with, would have been able to visualize. And that's what the parables do. They use the ordinary to take us a step further in examining something. They would have all been familiar with a vineyard, with an absentee landlord, with tenant farmers. All of that would have been part of their everyday experience. So, Jesus tells a story. This is the second one. The first one, when they challenge him. Well, let me back up a minute. This 21st chapter of Matthew, it begins with Jesus' triumphal entry into Jerusalem. Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. It moves from that to Jesus driving the money changers, the sellers, out of the temple. My Father's house should be a house of prayer. And then that leads to the religious leaders challenging Jesus' authority to do what he does. By what authority do you do what you do? And Jesus, in turn, challenges their authority as the religious leaders of the people. The first one of those parables that we heard last Sunday, the parable of the two sons. When Jesus asked them at the end of that parable, which son actually did the will of the Father? They're forced to admit the first son. And by admitting that, they condemn themselves because they're like the second son. They're more concerned about saving face, keeping authority, being in control than they are about doing the will of God. And so now Jesus tells them a second parable about the landowner and his vineyard that he leases out to tenant farmers. Now, could have been some tenant farmers might have been tempted to cheat a little on the accounts that they would render to the landlord, to the owner, in order to increase their take. But these tenants in this parable, they're not just stealing and cheating. They're committing serious crimes. Murder. Matthew's community, hearing this parable, would have understood the messengers, those stoned and killed, as the prophets. The prophets that God continually sent to God's people and that they rejected. They would have also recognized the heir as Jesus. The heir that the tenants take outside the vineyard and kill. Because Jewish law forbade executions inside the city walls of Jerusalem. That is why Jesus is taken out to Mount Calvary to be crucified, because it was outside the city walls. And so in the parable, the tenant farmers take the heir outside the walls of the vineyard to put him to death. Jesus once again puts the religious leaders in an awkward position. What do you think the landowner is going to do with those tenants? He will bring those wretched people to a wretched death. See, Jesus is not accusing the chief priests, the elders, of not recognizing his authority. He is accusing them of recognizing his authority and wanting to take it for themselves, wanting to continue to be in charge of God's people, over God's people. Have you not heard the scriptures? The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. And so Jesus says to them, because of this, the vineyard is going to be taken away from you. Now, the vineyard is not the chief priests and the elders, the religious leaders. The vineyard is Israel, the people of God. The vineyard is still the cherished plant of God. It's the tenants who are being removed, who are no longer in charge of the vineyard. The vineyard is being turned over to those who will produce good fruit. We are called to look at that parable, to recognize that we are now the heirs of those to whom the vineyard has been given to be taken care of. And are we producing the good fruit of the kingdom? Are we, by our lifestyle, producing the fruit of justice and of peace for all of God's children? If we are not doing that in our day-to-day life, then we need to ask that God remain with us, as the psalmist prays, and help us strive to do better. Help us strive to be the responsible stewards, the tenants of God's kingdom of peace and justice in the world, so that our lives touch the lives of others who touch the lives of others, and we continually build the kingdom of God. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Mindful of God's constant loving care in our own lives, we pause to make known our needs and the needs of all our sisters and brothers.
Let the church produce fruit for the kingdom of God through acts of love, humility, and compassion. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let the world's citizens grow in reverence for the sanctity of all human life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That refugees and immigrants be welcomed as children of God and receive the protection and assistance they need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are ill or near death, and those who care for them, know the reality of God's love through the community support. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And that all who gather at this table of love see in one another's eyes the love of Jesus, Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. For a just and lasting peace throughout the whole Middle East, and especially in the Holy Land, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, religious life, and good Christian marriage, especially from our parish family, and for those who serve the Lord in the single state, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On this feast day of St. Francis, for all of the Franciscan family, and especially our own Channel of Peace fraternity here locally, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the silent needs in our hearts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, we come before you grateful that you have called us to be your friends. We ask you to strengthen us that our lives will bear witness to the gospel of Jesus, for he lives and reigns forever and ever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his
name, for our good and for all souls in the church. Grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellspring of all blessing may be laid open before us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We have lifted them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed us in your own likeness and set us over the whole world in all of its wonder, to rule in your name over all you made and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so, with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when, as once for his disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith: when we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion.
Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis our Pope, Richard our Bishop, with all the bishops, priests, deacons, and the entire people your Son has made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and action to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all peoples may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your faith, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live there with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the apostles, the martyrs, and all your saints. We shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer one another the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ. Fill us the body of Christ. Mary the body of Christ. We may the Lord bless and keep you always in his peace and love. Johnny the body of Christ. JJ the body of Christ. Jack the body of Christ. Dylan the body of Christ. May the Lord bless and keep you in his peace and love. which the body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. John, the body of Christ. Mary, the body of Christ. Pearl, the body of Christ. Ken, the body of Christ. May the Lord bless and keep you in his peace and love. May the Lord bless and keep you in his peace and love. May the Lord bless and keep you in his peace and love. Erica, may the Lord bless and keep you in his peace and love. May the Lord bless and keep you in his peace and love. The body of Christ. May the Lord bless and keep you in his peace and love and heal you on the cross. The body of Christ. Receiving the body of Christ. Having the body of Christ. May the Lord bless and keep you always in his peace and love. Because may the Lord bless and keep you always in his peace and love. Lord, the body of Christ. Or we may the Lord bless and keep you always in his peace and love. Katie, the body of Christ. Abigail, the body of Christ. The body of Christ. Lynn, the body of Christ. Paul, the body of Christ. Lucy, the body of Christ. Ed, the body of Christ. On the body of Christ. Bob, the body of Christ. Kevin, the body of Christ. Barbara, the body of Christ. Sue, the body of Christ. Ralph, the body of Christ. Mitchell, the body of Christ. Bruce, the body of Christ. Lorraine, the body of Christ. The body of Christ. El cuerpo de Cristo. El cuerpo de Cristo. Dios te bendiga. El cuerpo de Cristo. Through the body of Christ. Blue, the body of Christ. Kevin, the body of Christ.
For those unable to be with us today, my Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let's pray. Almighty God, let the Eucharist we share fill us with your life. May the love of Christ, which we celebrate here, touch our lives and lead us to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you and keep you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Be merciful as your Father in heaven is merciful. And so with peace.
Thanks be to God. Our prayer to Saint Michael. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Again, I would remind you of our new normal and ask you to leave the kneeler down where you are so that the volunteers know what to disinfect after Mass. And we start exiting from the back and the front. Ushers will pass out the bulletins in the narthex.